Oh, that's huge.
This is the dimensions of the aquarium. Approximately, the tank is going to be 16 feet long, 3 feet wide, 3 feet tall, which is just over 1,000 gallons, specifically 1,077 gallons. It is not the 17-foot tank. It is not 21 feet. It is not the 22¾-foot tank that I originally planned to build, which would encompass from that wall to that wall. Reason being is, well, abundantly simple, and obviously for two reasons. If I go 16 feet, I can use dimensional lumber and I don't have to worry about any sort of breaks in the framing system. I could just use 16-foot long boards, making this build incredibly more simple. Then of course, I incorporated 3 60-gallon tanks over here that are must-haves. I'm doing fully planted breeding. This will be a plywood aquarium, meaning that the entire aquarium is mostly made out of plywood and boards, and then it has front viewing panels. I believe it's been since October of last year that I started gathering and collecting all the supplies to build this. That's the epoxy. We also ordered a full sheet of 1-inch thick cell cast acrylic that is 8 feet long, 4 feet wide. Rip that in half lengthwise. We now have 2 8-foot by 2-foot panels, meaning I'd have 16 feet of viewing area. If I go 17 feet, I'd have a little bit of space in between each one to brace it, because you can't just put two pieces of acrylic like this and expect it not to burst open. You have to have some sort of framing in between those two pieces right down the center and on each ends. But only going 16 feet means that if I do place them in here, I'm probably gonna have to shave off about 6 inches of each viewing panel to make sure they fit in here properly, which isn't a problem. It's gonna be a really big, really cool tank. The other benefit to me doing it in dimensional lumber is that it makes this build not only easier for me, more affordable, but easier for you as well. One of the things that I notice with a lot of people when they build plywood aquariums, I build a lot of them out of different materials and different methods and different ways, is a lot of people have them leak. And I always look at their tanks and I'm thinking, it doesn't have much to do with how you epoxied it or waterproofed the inside, but rather, once it started to fill and settle, wood tends to warp and bend if the stand is not perfectly true and flat. And that's what we're going to do. We're going to build the stand, or at least get it started, so we can get a good idea of what it's going to look like, the height and everything of it, plus have something to actually build the tank on. What are we gonna build the stand out of? Well, that's where this is gonna get a lot easier too. We're building it out of concrete blocks. Building it out of concrete blocks for a couple of reasons. Cheap, easy. It's a material that anybody could build one out of. Requires absolutely no tools. But my favorite thing is that you can manipulate the blocks in a way that you can't really do with a normal wood stand. We can angle them, put them in the middle, put them in all different places so you can have all different types of structural integrity. In fact, it reminds me of this tank. On the cover here is a 540-gallon aquarium built out of glass, and the base is plywood, and underneath all this fake rock was cinder blocks. I'm using the ones that are 8x8x16. They cost like a dollar something each. I'm going to be able to build this entire 16-foot, 1,000-gallon stand for like $80. And then I'm gonna paint them black. I might even wrap the bottom so you don't even see them. You know, the most beautiful part about this is, like I said, I had already purchased the acrylic as well as the epoxy months ago, like 5-6 months ago, something like that. I bought all the wood and the concrete blocks a few weeks ago and finally got it to the house. But because I was buying everything so slowly, it doesn't feel like I'm spending a lot of money. But I know I could build this entire system for less than $2,000. The beautiful part about this as well is that notice that this is all the support that I need, a few blocks every once in a while. And then I'm going to build a top frame like we typically do for the stands out of 2x10s. So if I stack three of these blocks on end, one on top of the other, because they're 8x8x16. If I stack them up, three of them, it'd be 24 inches tall, toss this onto it. We're looking at 34 inches tall, then a plywood top, and then another plywood for the tank. By the time we get to the stand, or the actual height of the stand finished, it'll be 3 feet tall. I'm excited for this build. Okay, so that should be enough. I only bought 36 blocks. And right now, I kind of want to figure out where everything's going to go. I'll paint the entire blocks, the stand, everything black, so it's going to look actually really nice. We're going to start with the back end first, it looks like. Yeah, six pillars. Whoa, that's going to be strong. I don't want to block off any of the electrical plugs, especially since these are GFCI, because if I block one off and it trips, because you never know, I might have a flood, I'll never be able to reset it without moving the tank. I'm doing this because I want to get a good idea of what it's going to look like, how tall the stand's going to be, and what I'll be able to do next. Oh darn. There's almost no way for me to not block this off. So let's start by making them 20 inches apart. Okay, there's roughly 20 inches of space in between each one. And obviously I got to clean them up and line them up and stuff. Again, I'm just getting these in here just to see what it's going to look like. This, that's the overall height of the stand, 32 inches tall. Let's say 33, put the stand on it, tank, let's call it 36 total. That's perfect right there. That's 3 feet. You see? Leaving a little more than, or a little under 3 feet there. These ceilings in here are like 8.5 feet tall, by the way. Yeah, that's gonna look good. Especially once I paint the floors, paint the bricks. Yeah, and once this is in place, I still have over 3 feet between the two, which is 3 feet is here to here. So that's more than enough space. Very cool. Yeah, I can easily build on top of this. This is gonna be one strong stand. I think that's all I could do for today. Get these in, get a good idea of what it's, oh, that's wet. Oh, well, I gotta get changed anyway. Get these in, I gotta wait for the concrete to dry before I can paint it, but that's it. And obviously line them up and put them in properly. For me, I probably just could have brought in a couple blocks, three blocks and a board, just to see the height. I couldn't wait, I needed to see it. But once these blocks dry, I'm going to paint them black, get them into space, and build the top. Maybe that'll be some of the next videos coming up here shortly. Anyways, happy Easter. It's Saturday today, Easter's tomorrow. So happy Easter, if you celebrate that. Anyways, wish me luck. Love you guys, see you in the next video.